The primary interdictor of traffic along the Ho Chi Minh Trail was a 10-year-old plane that became the most terrifying weapon of the war, the B-52 Stratofortress.
B-52 is a swept-wing, eight-engined, long-range bomber. It can refuel in flight. It can carry virtually any weapon.
Originally designed to carry nuclear warheads over Russia, the B-52 was converted to hold vast stores of 500 and 750-pound iron bombs. In December of 1965, the planes underwent a so-called big belly modification, increasing their bomb load to 60,000 pounds, 10 times the capacity of the famed B-17 in World War II.
They would squat at the end of the runway, black smoke boiling out from them. They're down on their shocks because they're so heavy, their wings are drooping. Finally, by the end of the runway, they would struggle into the air and become airborne.
The B-52 missions, designated Operation Arclight, were grueling 9-hour round trips from Andersen Air Force Base in Guam. Once over their jungle target, the bombers attacked in arrowhead formations of three planes each to maximize destruction in a mile by half mile area.
And when these things came down to Earth, they would simply make a carpet of destruction, which was unbelievable. The B-52 flies high, and you can neither, in the jungle, you could neither see it nor hear it coming, and they had no radar there. So all of a sudden, the ground would simply erupt. There would be a 30-second earthquake. There might or might not be anything left afterwards.
The B-52s inflicted massive punishment when the enemy could be found. But dense jungle cover and highly mobile Viet Cong forces made targeting difficult.
This was the first war in history in which the greatest weight of bombing was done on our allies' country.